There is a general regulations recommended as a minimum for the successful operation of a clean room. All professional personnel should be aware and follow these regulations at all times. First, all personal items such as keys, watches, rings, matches, lighters, and cigarettes should be stored in the personal locker outside the gowning room. Second, valuable personal items such as wallets may be permitted in the clean room provided they are never removed from beneath the clean room garments. Third, no eating, smoking, or gum chewing allowed inside the clean room. Fourth, only garments approved for the clean room should be worn when entering. Fifth, no cosmetics shall be worn in the clean rooms. This includes rouge, lipstick, eyeshadow, eyebrow pencil, mascara, eyeliner, false eyelashes, fingernail polish, hairspray, mousse, or the heavy use of aerosols, aftershaves, and perfumes. Sixth, only approved clean room paper shall be allowed in the clean room. Seventh, only approved ballpoint pens shall be the only writing tool used. Eighth, use of paper or fabric towels are prohibited. Use of hand dryers equipped with HEPA filters are suggested. Ninth, gloves or finger cots should not be allowed to touch any item or surface that has not been thoroughly cleaned. 10th, only approved gloves, powder-free finger cots, pliers, and tweezers should be used to handle product. Fingerprints can be a major source of contamination on some products. 11th, solvent contact with the bare skin should be avoided. They can remove skin oils and increase skin flaking. 12th, approved skin lotions or lanolin-based soaps are sometimes allowed. These can reduce skin flaking. 13th, all tools, containers, and fixtures used in the cleaning process should be cleaned to the same degree as the clean room surfaces. All of these items are a source of contamination. 14th, no tool should be allowed to rest on the surface of a bench or table. 15th, only clean room approved wipers are allowed to be used. The wipers must be approved for the class of clean room being cleaned. 16th, all equipment, materials, and containers introduced into a sterile facility must be subjected to stringent sterilization prior to entrance. 17th, no ONE who is physically ill, especially with respiratory or stomach disorders, may enter a sterile room. This is a good practice in any clean room environment. Finally, personal actions typically prohibited in clean rooms include fast motions such as running, walking fast, or horseplay, sitting or leaning on equipment or work surfaces, writing on equipment or garments, removal of items from beneath the clean room garments, wearing the clean room garment outside the clean room, and wearing torn or soiled garments.